that's nice for Mary, but a miracle could not happen for me because there's some things I just don't have that I believe are necessary ingredients. There's some things I've been through, there's some things I've done that I might feel eliminates me from having a purpose in God, if I'm having God work a miracle through me. Mary said, how can this be? Say, I don't know everything about this sex thing, but I do know if this going to be a baby, they don't come from the cabbage patch. I do know that you don't leave a tooth up under the pillow and then in 9 months the baby come out. And so she said, in the natural, it's impossible for this to be happening. And some of you are saying, God, you must not know about me. Because you know he said it's coming. You know he said it's happening. You know he said it's happening for you. But you're saying, how can this be? I want to submit just a couple of things for your consideration that first might make you sad, but then I hope it'll make you glad. We love to talk about Noah and how Noah built the ark. And how all of those years Noah built that. And it rained 40 days and it rained 40 nights and humanity got preserved in the ark. That's good. But we don't want to talk about how he got drunk. We don't want to talk about that. We don't want to talk about the incest that was in his family that was going to plague him and is still plaguing the earth today. We don't want to talk about that same one who was the ark builder. And Pastor Steve, I had to ask myself as I was looking at that. Now, there wasn't any liquor stores. Wasn't any liquor barn. I don't even know if that's still open. That date me. But where did he, I believe Noah had a stash on the ark. And he said, just as soon as this is over, we're going to do that thing. And we don't want to talk about that as it relates to God transforming folk and God using folk in spite of folk. But in spite of Noah's checkered past, God still used him. We want to talk about how Moses led the children of Israel through the wilderness. But we don't want to talk about when he killed that man and buried it. Now don't look around, because some of y'all know you have killed some folk. And I'm not talking about in the spirit. Some of us used to be a bang bang, shoot 'em up, bang bang. Some of you was in the gang and you wear long sleeves even in the summertime. You don't want to see how many folk you took out in the gang. Moses was a killer, but God still used him. We want to talk about how David slew Goliath. We want to talk about how he won for the father, won for the son, and hit him in the forehead, knocked him dead, cut off his head. We don't want to talk about how he was looking out one evening and saw that pretty girl. See, some of us godly men don't want to talk about our pretty girl problem. We don't want to talk about what God has delivered us from. My baby said, why are you home so early? I said, maybe my car go home with me when I got somewhere else to go. Brothers, I'm going to give you something for free. It might save your marriage. There's some decisions I make before I leave the bedroom in the morning. So when I run into it along the way, I've already made a choice before the choice. I know where home means.
Right.
Some choices you need to make before the choice. But we don't want to talk about what David did and the results of his sin and how God still said about David, he's a man after my own heart. We don't want to talk about that. We don't want to talk about how Paul used to be Saul and how Saul is what we now call a jailbird. Graduate from Folsom University. Graduate from San Quentin U. Graduate from Santa Rita Community College.
Yeah.
We don't want to talk about that. But God uses those kind of people in spite of themselves. And some of you need to know it is possible for God to use even you in spite of your history, in spite of your past, in spite of the things that you or your family has been through. already outlined, the possibility. But then as we move through from Thanksgiving to Christmas, we need to know now, okay, Mary said, be it unto me according to thy word. And here's the next step. After you realize that it is possible for God to have a purpose for you, you need to get around some miracle-minded people. Now, this is kind of hard, but you can blame it on the word, blame it on the Holy Ghost, or blame it on me. Either one of those is all right. In order for you to walk into your purpose, there's some folk you're going to have to leave behind. Mary accepted God's word, but then she got out of there. Why? Because if you hang around the old folk doing the old things that you used to do when you did what you did, they can be dream killers. They can give you 999 reasons why you can't go ahead and do what you know the Lord told you to do. And so she left her neighborhood, she left her community, and she went over to Elizabeth's house because she knew something was also growing in Elizabeth that was also a miracle baby, a miracle situation, and because she wanted God's purpose fulfilled in her life, she relocated. Let me share something with you. Glory to God. There's some of us, I'm not charging y'all for this, this is free. Some folk you need to love them enough to leave them. I better say it again. Some folk you need to love them enough to leave them. You know they're toxic for you. You know you're toxic for them. You're headed in opposite direction. And they will be a brick in your backpack if you don't learn how to tell them bye bye, baby. I need that to sink in. Bye bye, baby. It's been fun. It's been good. But I now know God's purpose for my life. And brothers, if you don't, and I can say this with no shame at all. Brothers, if you don't have the gift of singleness, you need to be looking for a wife. I better let that sink in. Because see, if you, let me say plainly, what's this gift of singleness? If you cannot live the rest of your life with no sex, you need a wife.
Amen.
Now, not just any wife. You need God to tailor make her for you. You see, God. My baby said, why are you with me? I said, because God tailor made you just for me. And brothers, can I encourage you? God is tailor-making exactly the wife you need if you don't have the gift of singleness. Ladies, let me tell you something the world don't want you to know. There are still some godly men in the earth. But if you got a Volkswagen parked in your garage, your Bentley won't fit. If you got a 10-speed tied to your pole, you can't get a stallion. And so why, when you done prayed for exactly what you wanted in God, are you shopping for a Mercedes at Walmart?
Well,
he said he'll give you the desires of your heart. Now, I know when I married Pauline, I married her. I don't care. He knew the desires of my heart. And so, but in glory. Brothers, if you got the wrong one, and when you get to your car, look at your passenger seat. And think about who you let sit there. And never again ride any lady in the passenger seat of your car who's not a princess getting ready to be a queen. How your princess gonna sit down when Trampolina is in her seat? No room. You said you too.
What you talking about, Pastor Mike?
He said you are a royal priesthood. Royalty, a holy nation. Royalty marries royalty. So if he's not a prince, then he's not qualified. He shouldn't even pass your paper screen. Need not apply for the job. And same thing for you, brothers. Can we talk?
Yeah.
Brothers, some of us got one woman for taking out, one woman for cooking, one woman for talking to, and I have the nerve to have another one for praying with. And you got all these pieces of woman, and if you put them all together, they don't equal one. And how can God send you the one you need when you got all these puzzle pieces hanging? Ladies, if Mr. Wonderful would show up right now, are you ready? I'm not going to tell you. I'm not going to name the names. Y'all might know what I'm talking about. This brother was getting ready to marry this woman until he went into the bathroom. And saw more rings around that bathtub than Saturn.
That is funny.
Don't you do it? I know it.
That is a good one. I've never heard that one.
Ladies, get ready for Mr. Wonderful. So we said, but Pastor, I'm too fat. There's some men who like it good and chunky. God is going to create in the man a desire for you. And he's going to accept you if you have already put your petition before God to let him feel the desires of your heart. I just saved somebody 3 divorces. 7. When God has told you, get me out. I said, well, Pastor, I love you. You get over it.
Okay, now.
She went over to Elizabeth's house because Elizabeth also was having a miracle happen. The people of the miracle get around some miracle-minded folk who will tell you what God said instead of what you want to hear. So the possibility of the people of the miracle, the people of purpose, and then progress. Now, you need to know, as it relates to miracles and as it relates to your purpose, God can do a right now miracle for you. God can part your Red Sea right now. God can heal your body right now. God can deliver you from the lion's den right now. God can send you one check that's more than all the money you've ever made in your whole life. But let me tell you something. Usually, a miracle takes time.
Amen.
I'm not going to read that. I can read the 2 chapters, the first and the second chapter. But at Elizabeth's house and with Mary, this thing took months. And then even after Jesus, the Son of God, was born into the flesh, it says, and he grew, Pastor Steve. And he grew in favor with both God and man. Now, something that I never thought about. Is it possible that your miracle is born but still growing? God has already planted that seed in you, and it's out. You can see it crawling around right now. But it's maturing, and God is working on it, and he's helping it grow, and it's coming, and it's happening, but it's going to take time. There's some miracles that God does not microwave. Bless God. Pastor Porsche is a kitchen mechanic. But it's some stuff she would never put in the microwave. Because if she gonna get that assumption in it, bless God, she was trying to have me be a cheese macaroni addict. If you have never had any of her cheese, I didn't say macaroni and cheese, I said cheese macaroni. If you don't go to heaven until you've had it. Because see, he said his kingdom would come on earth. baby, don't go to heaven until you taste her cheesy grits. You know, if you was thinking about dying, you said, baby, when you face them cheesy grits, I may die the day after that, but I'm going to live and not die. Because I shall have. But she doesn't just, you got to, glory. Oh, thank you, Lord. You got to gather the ingredients for some stuff. And you got to cook it slow. You got to let it mature. And you got to work with it. And God is working with some of our situations because he wants to mature us. He wants us to be ready to handle it. Aren't you glad God didn't give you $1 million while you was a dope fiend? Aren't you glad that God didn't give you your current husband when you were still shaking that money maker? Sons of God has to let us mature, has to let us take our time, has to cook it nice and slow so that when it gets there, it'll be good. And so for some of us, our miracle is progressing. It's taking time. God is maturing it and letting it grow in us, and we need to let God do it his way. Let me give you something that some of you need to hear today. There is your way, there is my way, and then there's God's way. I need to know that God is sovereign and he, glory, he's not taking a vote. He loves me too much. Some of us, bless God, you have some beautiful babies. But when they were 2 years old, let me tell you what you didn't do. You didn't give them a 12-inch butcher knife for Christmas.
All right.
Didn't do that. Why? Because no matter how shiny and how sharp it was, you knew they would slice themselves to bits. Because they had not yet developed the skills to handle such a tool. God has some things that are already on the way to your house. Some of you need to receive this in your spirit. Your husband is already on the way. Your new job is already on the way. Your blessing is already on the way. Your finances are already on the way. But you need to let God help you grow to the point where you can handle the purpose that he's placed in you. Somebody said, well, what is that? Like Pastor Mike, let me give you a new definition of something you've heard for all your life. A lot of us think wicked folk are folk who do all the bad stuff that we don't do. Let me give you a new definition of wicked. Wicked is living your life not considering God. At what point of your day do you say, God, I got this? You say, God, I'm going to do what I want to do, like I want to do it. And then later, I'm going, that's wickedness. And God is not going to bless my independence from him. As what would happen if all day, every day, you stop long enough to say, can I do this with God? God is waiting until we progress to the point, glory, where we set him free from Sunday morning from 10:30 to 1 and let him come to my house. Let him in my car. Let him into the corner in the back in the dark. This guy that, bless God, just a little bit over a week ago, I got back from Miami. And I said, I see why some folk don't go there. I see it in Miami, laying around on the sidewalk, just laying there.
It's pretty intense.
And I went there. Thank you for helping me. I went there because I had to speak to 100 school districts about what the Lord is doing in Oakland. But again, they invited me, my brother, to the meeting after the meeting. Where they had hot and cold running liquor for free. outside, I've never seen so many assisted bodies in my life. They got some extra in the front and some extra in the back, took some away and added some to their face in their attempt to be Ken and Barbie. But glory to God, because I baby can't ask any kind. I'm on my phone. I have this app. You may want to get it. It's called 360. It's called 360. And it lets my baby see me no matter where I am. I was, why would you do that, Pastor Mike? You done messed me up. Because where should I go that I don't want her to know? If we are one, and heart to heart, mind to mind, I shouldn't have to creep.
Well,
I shouldn't want to creep. As a matter of fact, my baby kind of knows my routine. If she don't get a text in the, if I got the word heard, if she don't get a text in the morning, sometime between 5:30 and 7, she knows. Sid, call 911. Something happened. Because our daddy's rock steady. And so, where should you go that you think God don't know?
Oh, now, come on.
And you know, he knows, but if you don't invite him in, he says, I stand at the door and I knock. Not only is God a gentleman, God, of all the things that God made, you're the only one that can choose. You have never seen a cat barking. Never seen a dog meowing. Never seen a horse going, because it doesn't have any choice. But we have a choice, and God wants us day by day, all along the way, to choose him so that we can progress toward him. Miracles make time. But two, again, I'm glad we have the grown-ups in the room. I need to tell you something about the miracle that God is doing in your life and the purpose that God has for you so you won't be deceived and run from the church. When your miracle shows up, when God starts blessing you above and beyond what you can ask or think, you are not maybe, you are going to be attacked.
All right.
Not maybe, but sure. And so then, I call that the persecution of the miracle. Jesus was born, and Herod sent out a decree, kill all the firstborns, all the ones who were born in this time frame. Because he knew somewhere in there was Jesus. Somewhere in there was God's purpose. Somewhere in there was what God was going to do. And you need to know, and some of you, we can have a testimony service all week long about how Satan put out a hit on you, but God protected you. Yes. For some of y'all, it was cancer. For some of y'all, you heard the bullet whiz past your head. Some of y'all had the bullet go in, but it just missed your heart by that much. Some of y'all, somebody came for you to kill you and forgot their way to your house. Well. Some of you, you usually go a certain way home, and some told you not that way today. And on that way, you saw the biggest accident you had ever seen, right at the spot where you would have been if you had gone that way. Satan already had a hit out on you, but God's purpose is greater. But you need to know, Jesus said, why are we so shocked? In the world, ye shall have tribulation.
Amen.
So why are we shocked when that devil we used to sleep with don't love us no more?
Woo, glory.
Why are we shocked when that job that we used to let steal from us fires us? Why are we shocked when as we go to do good, suddenly cars start breaking down, refrigerators start breaking down, gremlins. Your sweet acting, wonderful little angelic baby act like they demon possessed. Act like Legion. Run around buck naked, scratching themselves. Oh, would you act, you look like my baby? What would happen to you? from death. It's the persecution. One time, Pastor Steve, bless God for Pastor Steve, he said this young man to me who was considering suicide. And some of you need to hear this today, because I believe every Sunday there's at least one person in the room who was considering suicide. I have some good news for you today that's in line with your purpose, in line with the miracle God's working for you, and some of you may need to use this, if not for you, for someone you know before sunset today. Pastor Steve sent the young man to me. He said, Pastor Michael, you're going to kill myself. I said, what's your favorite sport? He said, football. I said, who did y'all tackle? He said, quarterback. I said, who else? He said, running back. I said, who else did they try to tackle? I said, wide receiver. I said, why did they try to tackle him? He said, because they had a ball. I said, how many things are going wrong? He said, 5 or 6. I said, well, then there's 5 or 6 more things that are about to go wrong. But you need to not only not kill yourself, you need to know that the reason life is trying to tackle you, the reason the devil is trying to tackle you is because you had a ball. Hey!
Hallelujah.
The devil would not be messing with you so badly unless he knew if you get the ball 3 times, worst case scenario, it's going to be a first down.
Hallelujah.
Because you're averaging at least 3.5 per carry. If you just get the ball. And every now and then you're going to bust one for a touchdown.
Well.
And so Satan tries to tackle you on the way because he knows you are a touchdown machine. If you just run the play. God done gave you the playbook. And you, next time the devil try to tackle you, when you get back in the huddle, you just say, God, give me the ball. Because you may not have thought about it, but one of the best compliments the devil can ever give you is to mess with you.
Yes.
He has just complimented you because you are such a threat to the kingdom of the devil. That he wants to stop you early because he knows if you keep running, if you keep holding on, if you keep doing God's purpose, touchdown, Jesus. A miracle is possible for you. You need to get around some miracle-minded, purposeful people. And you need to know that the purpose in God is not going to be microwave. You're going to have some stuff you're going to have to work it out. Not to get saved, but because you are saved. What does that look like, Pastor Mike? Look, you'll start out feeling like you're a slave. And then you'll know that it's better to serve Jesus than to be a kingpin in the world, because Satan is an Indian giver. He'll give you a car, but he'll take it back. Give you a house, but he'll take it back. And then when you realize, if you ever come to the realization that God wants you to graduate from being a servant to being a son and being a daughter, have you ever thought about you are adopted? You're in the royal family, and not only is God not broke, he has promised to supply all of your needs according to his riches and glory. Let me tell you something you may not have thought about. Everything you need today, you got it. Yes. You ever thought about that every now and then? My baby said, baby, what you want? Nisha, no, she said, what you need? I said, baby, I got it. Now, you want to give me something that's good. But everything I need, God.
Yes.
Yes. Let me tell you something about if you have Christ, everything you need, you got it. I get broke, God don't get broke. his seat is more healing in the hem of his garment than Kaiser, Stanford, and HealthNet, all of them combined. And God didn't have to show up. He just said, healed over there. Everything you need is God. And he will not withhold any good thing from you as long as he knows you can glorify him with it. Okay, we're between Thanksgiving and Christmas. Let me give you this and then gather your stuff because we're going to the altar. We're going to praise for some miracles and then I'm going to be looking for a report. Yeah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. We look and sometimes we're so busy looking around that we forget to look up.
Well,
somebody needs to write this down. This is about to set somebody free. It is impossible to worry and worship at the same time. So now I'm going to ask you, what are you worrying about? And I want to submit for your consideration, that is the area where you need to start worshiping. Are you worried about money? You need to magnify the Lord. What does that mean? Glory. Brother Curry talked about it this morning. When you magnify something, you make it big in comparison to what else is around. So are you magnifying your worry or are you magnifying your God? Are you letting God be small in the presence of what you're worrying about? Or are you letting God be big? Bigger than whatever you're worrying about. And so whatever you are worrying about, start saying, my God is greater. Yeah. My God is bigger. Yeah. My God is more than enough. Yeah. And even though it seems to be cooking slowly,
okay.
God's miracle, God's purpose in my life is progressing.
Yeah.
I want to ask everybody to stand. And you don't have to, but I want you to consider this. Everybody stand. At those who would, and I'm giving you four specific areas, and I'm inviting you to the altar, not just any unsaved folk. I'm talking about some saved folk who are having trouble in one of these four areas. Satan's been trying to tackle you. Satan's been trying to tackle your purpose. I'm going to invite you to the altar, first of all, if you are worried about your money. I call these the four pillars. The four pillars. If you want God to do something supernatural in your finances, come forward. Come forward. Come forward. You don't need to be ashamed. I'm already up here.
Okay.
I'm looking for the Lord to totally pay off my house, pay off my car. Bless God, all my credit cards are already good at zero balance.